Let's dive into some Tactica for Chain of Command World War II. An amazing system, amazing rule set, and some really interesting innovations. But I want to share with you some of the Tactica that I utilize and I look at, especially when playing late war Germans. So from that perspective, what's interesting about historicals, just for the kind of the framework, you know, many wargaming systems, it's like, okay, you've got 1,000 battle value or 150 squadron points or 200 power points, and you open up the book and you buy your units and you fight. Historical wargaming and chain of command being historical, what's the time period? What's the time period? That time period and that narrative is going to show what you can play and what you can reasonably have access to play. Big units, small units, innovative technology. You know, if I want to play early war Germans and put down some tanks, yeah, I'm going to have a lot more officers. I'm going to have a lot more men on the table. I'm not going to have a panther. I'm not going to have a tiger or a king tiger tank. I'm not going to have that late war tank tech. Likewise, and this is honestly why I like to play late war, I love tanks in games. So I can play Chain of Command, throw down tigers, throw down all these amazing tanks. Yes, they are literally beast mode on the table. But my infantry squads are really small. My command structure is really small. So what are some of the tactics in game to look at that? That's kind of the narrative, the setup. So the big thing in Chain of Command is the junior officers and the senior officers, junior leader, senior leader. Junior officers attach as part of the squads, and they can issue orders. They can take shock off. The senior leaders are very powerful in that they can issue orders to other units, and they can remove shock. Depending on the dice roll, if I can activate a senior leader or senior officer, if I can activate two of them, I can issue six orders on that turn. So I could be like, you fire, remove shock there, activate that unit. I mean, it offers tremendous flexibility. And where it builds in the redundancy is that at the start of the turn, when you roll your dice to see what units you can activate, or if you can generate a chain of command die, or, you know, hopefully a couple of sixes and have the game turn end, or get another go, you don't always get what you want, especially if you've taken a hit and you've lost a command die or two here as you move down on the scale. Having those senior officers, it's huge. It's huge. It's especially huge in pulling off shock to get a unit out of there, because as you get mauled and as you get beat up, eventually with the losses that you take, the unit becomes so small, the shock will pin it. Or once it's broken, that's a little bit different. But now you're forced with, I want to get that unit out of there, but I can't. But if I have a senior officer that I can take shock off, I can then get the unit out of there, hide it, and not be forced to roll on the chart to see, do I lose command dice or not? So massive, massive, massive. As late war, playing the German army late war, stock, they only come with one senior officer because the command structure has been decimated. I can get a second one on the table, depending on the scenario, but I'm paying support choices for that. I'm paying support points. And one could argue, if you're playing late war, the advantage that the Germans have is having some of that wonder tech, having some of those powerful tanks. I want to spend all my support points as much as I can, even if I'm going to get like one or two tanks on the table, from that perspective. So how do we get around this duality of putting everything into the tanks, but how do I deal with the lack of support? We're going to turn that to the advantage. I find the Germans outside of tanks want to really leverage the machine guns. And some of the late war units, squads, they're smaller in size, so you're vulnerable to shock, you're vulnerable to losses, but they come standard with two machine guns. Other support choices based on the mission, or if I have so many points, I can also get a tank. Not so much mortar teams, snipers. I mean, I love them, but taking additional machine guns. If I can blanket the table with machine guns, I can't stop playing against the British or playing against the Americans. The fact that they have senior officers that come with two standard in the army lists, you dump some more points and you get a third. One could argue that you don't need the third, but it's an option. I want to use that as a disadvantage in that I can't stop you from issuing those orders, but by volume of dice, I can increase the random and possibly wound or kill that senior officer. So every time a unit gets hit, if there's a junior officer or a senior officer in there because you're shooting into the unit, you roll a d6. And there's a chance that one of those kills, right? If I score three shock and two kills, that would actually be a really good roll. I'll take that roll. Actually, I don't want to use that roll now. I want to save that for that game. But if I take three shock, two kills, I distribute the shock to the unit, I have to roll for the kills because those kills might be a junior or senior officer. If I wound or I kill that junior senior officer, that's a roll on the chart, especially if it's a senior officer. You're not getting away for free. Now, hopefully you've banked a chain of command die, so this way you could spend it and not be forced to make that roll. But maybe you've used it to redeploy or ambush or end a turn. I mean, there's other reasons to use it. I like to always try and bank one just in case, but I'm not opposed to using it for an awesome interrupt or an awesome ambush. So taking the machine guns means I can put out a high volume of dice, much more than a regular fire team can. And just by that volume of dice, try to get two kills a turn. Try to get two or three kills a turn. I mean, it's almost like, yeah, I want the shock too, but shock is secondary. I want to get two or three kills, so hopefully I can leverage that on your senior officers, because the parallel function is, if you have the advantage with the senior officers, you want to get them out there. You want to literally overwhelm my command structure and issuing orders and deploy all your units on the table, because you're going to be able to push out a lot more orders and activate a lot more units by default than the Germans can. But I want to use that to punish you. I want to use that to go against you. So that's kind of some of the tactics, and that's what I'm looking at. I do play a sniper from time to time. The sniper does have an increased chance to hit or target a leader where appropriate, but it's one shot. It's points. I'd rather spend those points on tanks, if possible. I'd rather spend those points on some other elements, some machine gun teams, if possible. I'm not saying don't take a sniper, but if you're going to look to directly affect the command structure and target senior and junior leaders, I think just volume of dice. Volume of dice is the way to do it.